Game mechanics or game dynamics are what make good games work. Game dynamics give players a reason to keep playing. Educators can build game dynamics into their classes to make them more engaging and motivating for their students. In this video, we'll introduce some popular game dynamics by showing you how they work in games and how they might work in a classroom. One popular game dynamic is the appointment dynamic, known as be here now and get a prize. Movie theaters often offer a bargain matinee. This gives you a reward for showing up at a certain time to see a movie at half price. Games like Farmville and Animal Crossing also give players bonuses for showing up at a day or a time. In the classroom, you can use the appointment dynamic by making classroom activities an event, such as writing hour or project time. One way to use the appointment dynamic in school is to create a viewing party where students watch a TED Talk or other lecture together, even if they are online in different locations. We use a real-time chat tool, such as Skype Instant Messaging, to have a backchannel chat that can be saved. This allows students to ask questions and discuss topics in a time-stamped transcript and can later be reviewed along with the video. It's also helpful for students who don't make it to the event. Another game dynamic is the flexibility dynamic. This means providing multiple paths to success. Many popular games allow you to win in different ways. You might race to the end and be the first to finish, or you might be the one who picks up all the stuff. The scoring systems are weighted to reward either style of gameplay. What does this look like in school? Consider Harvard's Universal Design for Learning framework, which calls for flexibility in representation, how you provide information to students, flexibility in expression, giving students choice in how they express their learning, and flexibility in engagement, which means switching up the types of activities to engage different types of students. Another way to embed the flexibility dynamic in your class is to provide lots of learning resources to your kids and allow them to choose a path toward mastery that makes sense. Think of it this way. In college, you declare a major and choose electives that build your mastery in a certain area of interest, but you also have certain required courses too. What if kids could do this in every course? Look at your curriculum. What are the required units? What possible electives or branches could students choose to study? You might ask every student to complete the required portions of your course, but allow freedom to choose two or three electives in an area of interest. Choice can build engagement. Powerful learning happens when kids are actively engaged. In some games, the only way to succeed is to fail repeatedly. Failure is becoming more and more recognized as an essential part of learning toward mastery. The whole idea of failure becomes a way to get more information about the level so that when you do succeed, it is because of all the essential information you gained from failing. That makes failure seem less like game over and a lot more like an essential part of the game. This is called the failure dynamic. Many successful entrepreneurs have run several failing companies before finally succeeding. There is even an annual conference dedicated to learning from failure. As teachers, how can we get better at allowing our students to fail frequently in small ways? Most grading systems do not allow for failure as a way to improve learning. One poor grade can greatly impact a student's average. This discourages risk-taking. Allowing students to work through failure, whether it's through a game or through more traditional types of learning, encourages kids to take risks and try different approaches in other aspects of their life. Many online tools, such as Socrative or Kahoot, allow students to participate in fun quizzes or surveys during a lesson. You can create a fun game show atmosphere in your classroom, and if you want, you can even have students compete anonymously, which allows them a safe way to find out what concepts they may still need to work on. By the way, you have completed 60% of the course so far, so we have a special surprise for you. Here is a badge you can display with pride. You weren't expecting to get a prize. After all, you aren't done yet. but it feels good to celebrate the good work you've done along the way, doesn't it? That's the progression dynamic at work. As gamers play a game like Forza Horizon or other racing games, they will sometimes receive recognition for completing a certain number of challenges or for passing some number of obstacles. Many players aren't even aware that the achievement even existed. It's just a nice milestone to complete on the way to winning the game. In school, we can always find more opportunities to provide more positive reinforcement to our students. Perhaps a badge or a way to go to let kids know they're on the right path to success. You can award a OneNote sticker to students who complete a certain number of challenges on the way to completing a big project. Just remember that ideally, low scores on these formative challenges shouldn't sink your final score. Otherwise, you're going against the failure dynamic. Remember, you don't always have to use games in class to make learning stick. By using some of the game dynamics we've talked about, you can allow students to engage in frequent, low-stakes failure as a way of getting better. Create events in class to increase attention and engagement, provide multiple paths to success in your classes, and provide constant feedback in small ways to guide their learning. These are all positive ways to use the science of games to create a more effective learning environment.